So you've taken delivery of your new R1300GS, you're really excited about all the technology and the improvements over the previous model, but now you've realized that there is one area that has gone backwards, and that is the illumination on the rear of the motorcycle. BMW, in their infinite wisdom, have decided to remove the tail lamp assembly. Now, the tail lamp assembly is really important on big bikes like this. It increases our presence and visibility on the road. And even on the 1250, we had a nice, great, big, fat brake light in the center on the rear to help road users behind understand what we're doing when we're making lane changes and braking. But BMW have removed that now, and all of those functions are taking place inside those little tiny indicators. And I don't understand it. BMW, please bring it back. This really isn't acceptable on a premium motorbike to have no tail lamp assembly. Please bring it back. However, that means that for those of you that have bought the R1300, you have a decision to make. Do you put up with the limitations that the bike comes with from stock, or do you do something about it? Weiser also realized that, you know, people, when you spent this much money, and they are very expensive motorbikes, you don't always have a lot left to add accessories and options afterwards. So they wanted to find a cost-effective version. So this is Weiser-Technik's Wizard Module Kit. This is the most cost-effective way to make an improvement to the rear of your R1300GS. Now, these modules, the key thing with these modules is they are plug and play. You remove the seat, you disconnect two connectors, you install the modules from Weiser-Technik, they're fully CANbus compatible, they're pre-programmed, there's nothing you need to do, reconnect everything, put your seat back on, and away you go. And immediately you have an improvement in terms of functionality and separating out that indicator, and it's really important, and we'll have a look in a second, on the rear of the bike. However, even when you install these, there is still a compromise on the rear of the bike. So what Weiser have done, there is another way to buy this. So you can buy this as a standalone product if you just want to improve the functions on the rear. But there is another way. You can buy this kit with an approved third-party tail lamp assembly. And then during the ordering process, you just have to decide how many additional functions you want to take place in that tail light. For example, you can have just one function, which for me, someone that lives in Germany, I have to have because of the rules and regulations. So I can add in a great big fat brake light on the back of my bike, which is great. But for those of you in the UK, you also have the option to have an additional function. So you have two. You would have a rear tail light or a side light, plus a brake light in the center of the bike. So there are some options. So when you place your order with Weiser-Technik, you just need to make up your mind in terms of your geographical location, what you want to have on the rear of your bike. Do you want to have just a brake light, or do you want a tail light and a brake light and fit these modified kits? So Weiser will have on their website a list of compatible third-party modules so that you can choose the style, whether you have six LEDs, three LEDs and so on. They'll have a selection on their website. And the important thing is when you place your order, the kit that comes from Weiser-Technik is going to be pre-programmed. You don't need to do anything at all. There is no need to fit a CANbus controller. There's no need to have a laptop and then software and then program it. It'll all come pre-programmed, and it's just plug and play. Modules, you choose your tail light, take everything apart, plug it in, and away you go. It's that simple. So what we'll do, I'll spin the bike around. We'll do a very quick look at the limitations of the standard BMW system. Then I'll install these Wizard modules and show you what the improvements are straight out the box with a 10-minute job. It's that quick. And then I'll also install a third-party tail light. I'll probably put it underneath the number plate for ease of mounting and show you what you can have in terms of those additional tail light and brake light functions. And that really does put back the presence and illumination we really should have on a big expensive touring adventure bike. So in a moment, I'm going to show you how to fit these modules and just how quick and simple it is to install them. Then we'll have a look at the changes. But first, what we really should do is have a quick look at how it comes from the factory. So the first thing you're going to notice, there is no big tail light. It is gone. So all three functions, side light, indicator and brake lights, have to take place inside these quite small indicators. So the ignition's on, this is the tail light, brake light, tail light, brake light. Now, I don't have a problem with this. This works fine, and in terms of visibility out there on the road, you can clearly see what's going on. But the problem happens is when we start to add in that third function, which is the indicator. So already there's a conflict, because the indicator should be just doing its single job. It should be flashing, and then there should be nothing else going on. But currently, in the background, the tail light is remaining on. So there's a restriction already. But then when we add in the brake light on top of, can you actually see what's going on inside there? It really isn't very clear. And it gets worse. If we're then slowing down through traffic, while we're indicating to traffic users behind us that we want to turn right, brake on, off. Maybe we're slowing down some more, off. It is really confusing. Now, in here today in the workshop, it is quite dark outside. So you're seeing the lights on the back of the bike in their optimal configuration. This is the best you're gonna see them. And let me tell you, when you're out on the road and it's a bright day, it gets even worse. And then you add on top sunshine, it is really hard to see what's going on inside that indicator unit when we're braking. So we'll fit the modules and then we will come back, have a look and see what the changes have done. So let's start with the installation. So I've removed the passenger seat and the rider's seat. And I'm also now going to remove this cross brace. Now, I'm going to remove it because it makes it easier for me to film and to show you what I'm going to do. This is a TX40, one, two, three, four of them. All we're actually trying to access are the indicator connectors, which there's one here and there's a second one here. And we're going to lift those out and then fit this little tiny module that comes from Weiser-Technik. So what I'll do, I'll take that cross brace off so that we have much more access and you can see more clearly, very, very quickly. And it's less than a minute's worth of work. But what it will enable us to do, and if you have the tools to do it, it just gives you a little bit more working space to fit the modules. Now, the screws, the bolts, are all the same length, so we don't need to worry about those. That's what they look like, and the bar we can just lift over and put out the way. So now, hopefully, you can see a bit more clearly. This is the connector that we need to unhook, and this is the second one. And these both actually come off very easy. So I'm just going to take my finger and very gently lift that out of that connector there. Like so. That's one indicator connector out the way. And then this is the second one. I'm going to put my finger in here and just lift that out like so. So then we have one indicator connector, the second indicator connector. And all we're going to do is we're going to mount the Weiser-Technik module in here. Now, this isn't handed, so you can't get this wrong. Whichever way you fit it, it's going to work. And because there are both female and male ends on here, we can't connect this the wrong way around, so it's foolproof. Now, these connectors do actually come apart. You don't need to use a screwdriver. You can, I've showed you this in the past with some of the videos, you can place the screwdriver under there ever so gently and then just wiggle that and these pop apart. But you don't actually need to use a screwdriver. You can just use your fingernail underneath there, a little bit of lifting and they come off. So we've now disconnected the two indicators. So what we need to do with the modules is connect them in between. So this is one, you can do them one at a time if you want, and we just need to connect them in there. And we can't get these wrong. If I move that right out of the way, they're only going to fit one way. We can't connect two male connectors. We can only go male to female. So the only thing we have to make sure about is these clips, these connectors, have a little tiny nipple on the top here. And if we look at the Weiser-Technik one, these are the same that BMW use. And if we turn it over, we'll see there's a place here for that little nipple to fit. So we just need to make sure that that clips. And if I'm quiet and you'll hear it clips into place. So we can't get that wrong. And the other end, we just connect in the same way. We make sure that the nipple is facing upwards. We've got the connecting part there and push them firmly together. So that's the first one done. So then we just need to do the same on the second one. It's a similar process. We can't get this wrong because they're male and female. We can't connect them the wrong way around. Turn them over with the nipple facing upwards, push in, clip. then take the other end, turn it over, push it in. If I'm quiet again. Okay, so that's them connected. All we need to do now is tidy things up. Now, inside the Weiser-Technik kit, there are some cable ties. So if you want to stop at that point and not clip them back in, you can, of course, cable tie them in. I'm going to clip them back in. They are a little fiddly to put back into those metal clips, but we should be able to do that without too much trouble. And it is just difficult in such a small space. So that's the first one. And then we need to get this second one. We'll move that out the way. And we're going to go into this, use the screwdriver, this connector here, this metal clip with this one. And that clips in. And then we can just tuck those cables out the way underneath the frame like so. And so we've got a nice neat installation. So all we need to do now is to refit the cross brace and remount our four TX40 bolts, do them up nice and tight, refit our passenger seat and our rider seat, and we are done. So I'll mount the bolts back in, put the seats back on, turn the bike around, and let's have a look at the changes that those simple modules make to improve that visibility on the rear. So now you've seen just how quick and easy these modules are to install, what changes do they make to the bike? Because this is the important part. So ignition on, we've got our side lights, nothing's changed. We add our brake lights in, side light, brake light, side light, brake light, still nothing has changed. But the magic starts to happen when we start to add the indicators in. So we'll put that right hand indicator on. Now you can immediately see that in the off phase of the indicator, that tail light is now deactivated. So it makes it much easier for traffic users behind to see what's going on in the indicator. But now we're going to add in the brake light, and the same thing happens. The brake light is not allowed to work in the side of the indicator that's doing the flashing. So we still have the brake light going on and off. Cover that up, side light, brake light, side light, brake light. On the other side of the bike, that's still working as original. But this side, the modules have deactivated the tail light illumination, and when we add in the brake light illumination, to leave this indicator free to do its single most important job of let people know following behind we are making a direction change. Now, there is one other thing, and this took Weiser a little while to figure out. There is another scenario when we're riding our bikes, which we have to take into account, which is what's going to happen when we use our hazard warning lights and our brake lights. And now this is not a condition on the roads that we often ride in, but there are times when we're on the motorway, for example, and we're steaming along and all of a sudden all the traffic's braking really hard in front. Someone's put their hazards on to let us know they're slowing down really fast and we want to do the same. So there has to be a way, which Weiser-Technik have found, to detect what's going on in terms of that combination of hazard warning lights being applied and then brake lights being applied, because as we've just seen, the system deactivates tail light and brake light when the indicator's going. So let me just demonstrate that, because it's really quite important that we make sure that function still works. So now we've got, it still works like it did from the factory. And at this point, it doesn't change anything. So we've got our side lights with our hazards going. And then when we add our brake lights in, we still got quite a bit of confusion going on, because we've got all three functions taking place, but the system from Weiser-Technik, the modules we've just installed, detect that that is what we're requesting, hazards and brakes and tail lights, and it lets everything work. All the CANbus signals go straight through to the rear lights, just as it was designed to when it left the factory. So we can have our brake lights with our hazard warning lights on. But importantly, the most important thing is when we're indicating, it turns everything off so that traffic users behind can see, even when we're braking, that the indicator is working clearly. And in the off phase, there's nothing else going on in there. So as you've probably just seen, it is really simple to install, and it's a 5-minute job. It's really not very difficult at all. However, there is another solution coming up just around the corner from Weiser-Technik. And I went to their offices in February this year and they showed me several of their products. I can't tell you about all of them, and I did do some filming while I was there, which you're going to see in a moment. And so another one of their products, they have developed a way so that you can add an additional tail light. Now, for those of you that already have a CANbus interface mounted on your bikes, of course, you can simply do that. You can connect it to your CANbus interface and add an additional tail lamp or brake lamp on the bottom or under the number plate up here or even up the top. But what Weiser-Technik have developed, and I can't show you full of it, I'm going to show you some of it in a moment, is a way to do that, to add a tail light, so that you can then also decide whether you have tail and brake light, and I'll explain why in a moment, without having to have a CANbus interface. And this is really important because those CANbus interface systems are jolly expensive. Then we also need a laptop, we need laptop software, we need a bit of experience with programming, and we need to know what we're doing to set them up. And so while they were going through the development phase, when I went over in February, we talked a lot about surely there must be a way to add in an extra tail light on the bottom without having to have this sort of CANbus interface, which they've done. This is what it could look like on the back of your R1300. So now we've installed this additional center light assembly. For this example, it's been programmed to do two functions. It is both a side tail light and a brake light. And importantly, when we add the foot brake in, this is what we should have on the back of our R1300s, a nice big, highly visible brake light. Now the other functions that we showed you earlier on haven't changed because we've got the Wizard modules installed. So when the bike is indicating, as you can see over here, it is only doing one function, which is letting traffic users behind following us know we're about to make a direction change. And even if we add in the brake light, we've got a brake light here, we've got a nice new big brake light here. Over here on the indicator, there's nothing else going on. It's just letting traffic know we're about to make a direction change. The bike is now compliant in Germany and many parts of Europe, but what it still retains is the brake light. So in terms of the European laws, we've got two tail lights, we've got three brake lights, all of which is permissible. And this is really quite a big step forward for Weiser-Technik, making sure that their products are compliant in different zones, geographical zones, and different locations. So overall, that is what we can do with the central brake light. At the time of order, you can choose whether you have one function or two functions when you place your order, depending on which one you're going to install. And then of course, in terms of location, you can mount it below the number plate, you can mount it above the number plate. So you've got plenty of options to add a good amount of visibility on the rear of our bikes and improve safety. Anyway, let's move on. Now you can clearly see you've got several routes to improve the rear visibility and the presence of you and your motorbike out on the road. You can do the really cost-effective route of fitting the Weiser-Technik Wizard modules by themselves, or you can fit the tail light as I've just shown you, or if you want to watch the video at the end of this, I'll put a link to it, and physically replace the indicators, the pair on the rear, the pair on the front, and add some functionality in that process too. There's another kit, the premium kit, that you can choose. But we now have a way to improve the R1300 because we need more visibility, more presence on the rear of our motorbikes to keep us riders safe. Anyway, thank you very much for your time today. I've got a lot to come this season. There's an awful lot more that I'm currently working on. Thank you for your time. See you soon.